Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. And here we are going to discuss the inventory model, the various problems in the inventory, maintaining inventory. We are going to discuss. This is lecture number 6.1 in the inventory model. The topic for discussion, we are going to discuss the inventory model types, deterministic model. So we take deterministic model. What there are different inventory models. We take the first model of the deterministic type, and we solve the model and we solve problem. So we derive the solution for the model, and we solve few problems in the inventory model one. The learning outcome to the students: at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the deterministic inventory model. Inventory model. What is inventory? Any kind of usable but idle resources are known as inventories. So this is very much related with the business enterprises, not only business enterprises and also the manufacturing unit. In the manufacturing unit, the inventory may be a different level. Inventory and the stock, we have the raw material as inventory, we have the finished product as inventory, we have the material and the process as inventory. So the any kind of usable but idle resources is known as inventory. In a big shopping mall or a departmental store, there are different inventory, different items they are stored, certain quantity of each item is maintained. If the resources are material, then it is called a stock. For example, a department store, store of the workshop. So there it is called as stock. The stock may contain raw material, material in process, finished product, or any item, grocery item stored in the department store. Or even you take anything in a sales department, you have a huge outlet of a TV company, they have different TV model as a stock. You take any commodity which is the outlet of any commodity or selling per sales point of any commodity, we have certain level of stock. All companies should maintain an optimum level of stock for the smooth running. So the optimum level, that is what the task, that is what the question here. We have to identify the optimum level of stock based on our mathematical model, mathematical solution for different inventory models. When the optimum level is not maintained, what will happen? So when the stock level is more than, then it is known as overstocking. We define the optimal level. If the stock level is more than the optimal level, then it is called as overstocking, which leads to increase the cost of holding the stock. If the stock level is less, then it is called as understocking, which leads to increase the number of purchases and cost of purchasing. So frequently we have to place order. So these are all the problems with overstocking or understocking. Inventory model focus on minimize the total cost involved in finding the answer to for the two questions: when to place order, so what is the time at which you have to place the order, then what must be the quantity of order, how much to order. So these are all the two questions to be answered here in the inventory model for different inventory model problem or models. Inventory cost. There are different types of costs involved in the inventory. There are four different costs involved in the inventory. One is purchase cost, the cost of item or good purchased, which depends on the unit cost. So cost of purchasing. So suppose you have 100 item of a particular commodity, so 100 into unit cost, that is the purchasing cost. Inventory carrying cost or holding cost. So what is the cost structure? The cost includes the cost of money tied up with the inventory, storage space cost, rent of the storage space, depreciation, handling cost, everything. So what is the cost required for holding the item inside the factory or inside the department store? That is what holding cost. If the stock level increases, the holding cost increases, and in the problem it is denoted by C1. Then setup cost. The cost required for setting up the stock is known as the setup cost or ordering cost. So we have to place order. The transportation cost, requisition cost, receiving the good, quality control, everything is included here. So, from the day of purchasing the order, receipt of the good, and the placing the item in the department store or the storage area, the cost involved between these two, ordering and receiving and placing the item in the department store, department stock area, it is called a setup cost, and this is denoted by C3. And shortage cost, the loss of money because of no stock or shortage of material in hand, that is given by C2, shortage. Suppose there is a shortage of material and you will be losing the profit, you will be losing the money. So, that is called as shortage cost. Then the different types of inventory model. So, elementary model. So, inventory model with a deterministic demand, inventory model with a probabilistic demand, model with the price breaks, and model with restrictions. So, these are all the three different types of inventory model. So, here in this lecture series, we are going to discuss about the elementary model, deterministic model, probabilistic model, and the model with the price breaks. So, inventory model with the deterministic demand. So, the various terminology, K is the production rate per unit time per unit time, R is the demand rate per unit time, C1 is the cost of holding the stock per unit time, and shortage cost, C2 is the shortage cost per unit time, and C3 is the setup cost, T is the time interval between the orders, and the Q, small q, is the stock level or the inventory level. So, these are all the terminologies we are going to use in the problem of deterministic model. And first model, so the model number 1, the various assumptions are there is no shortage permitted, so C2 becomes 0. And the demand rate is uniform. So, what do you mean by demand rate is uniform? Every day, suppose we establish a model for a month or a year, every day the demand of a particular item is uniform. For example, 10 items is consumed every day, that is what demand rate is uniform. And the production rate is infinite. So, K tends to infinity. What do you mean by production rate is infinite? If you place order, immediately you will get the stock. So, there is no lead time. Now, this is the diagrammatic representation of the model 1. So, what is the model 1? There is no shortage, demand rate is uniform, and the production rate is infinite. So, what is the meaning of the right angle triangle? So, OAB is one interval. So, from here, at the time beginning of the model, the stock level is up to A. So, stock level is Q. So, A is the point. Now, the stock level decreases. As the time increases, the stock level decreases. So, here the stock level is, demand rate is uniform. The stock level at the beginning of the model Q equal to R into T. R is the demand rate, T is the time. The stock level decreases at a uniform rate as time passes, and when the point B is reached, the stock level is 0 at the end of the time T. So, B is the stock level equal to 0. Now, we place the order. Immediately, the order is placed, and the stock level is raised to Q once again, because there is production that is infinite. So, the production that is infinite means any number of product can be purchased, any number of product can be procured at a zero time. Immediately, when you place the order, immediately the stock level will increase. So, this is the first model, deterministic model without shortage, rate of demand is uniform, and the production that is infinite. Now, we have to calculate the cost, and we have to optimize the parameter, cost of the inventory model. The cost involved in the model, holding cost equal to holding cost per item per unit time into area of the rectangle OAB, because area indicates total number of items. So, this is C1, holding cost 1 by 2 Q into T, half B into H. So, B is the time, H is the Q. So, half B H is the area of the triangle. So, C1 1 by 2 R T square. So, this Q, substituting Q here. So, Q equal to R into T. So, R T square. So, 1 by 2 C1 R T square is the holding cost. And the setup cost equal to C3. There is no shortage cost. We have only setup cost. Setup cost is C3. And the total cost equal to holding cost plus setup cost. So, C equal to 1 by 2 C1 R T square plus C3. And here, C1, C3 are constant, and it R is the demand rate, which is uniform, T is the time, the average cost per unit time. So, we calculate the average cost, so dividing by the time, so C by T, so total cost divided by the time, which is 1 by 2 C1 RT plus C3 by T. Now, we have to optimize this equation. So, for optimization, we have to differentiate this equation with respect to T and equal to 0. So, the cost will be optimum if dc by dt equal to 0 and d square c by dt square is greater than 0, positive. That means greater than 0 means positive. Now, differentiating the cost equation, c equal to 1 by 2 c1 rt into c3 by 2. First differentiation, dc by dt equal to 1 by 2 c1 r plus c3 minus c3 by t square, and differentiating again, it becomes d square c by dt square equal to 2 c3 by t cube, which is positive. Now, from the second, so we have to equate the second equation to 0. So, equating to 0, 1 by 2 c1 r minus c3 by t square equal to 0, rearranging 1 by 2 c1 r equal to c3 by t square. So, t, optimum time t equal to 2 c3 by c1 r. So, square root of 2 c3 by c1 r is the optimum time interval between the orders. Now, we calculate the optimum stock level, QO equal to R into TO. So, R into square root of 2 C3 by C1 R, which is equal to square root of 2 C3 R by C1. So, the optimum stock level equal to 2 C3 R by C1. And the optimum cost equal to C. C equal to 1 by 2 C1 R T plus C3 by T. So, substituting for T, the optimum time. So, C equal to 1 by 2 C1 R into square root of 2 C3 by C1 R plus C3 into 1 by t. So, 1 by t equal to c1 square root of c1 r divided by 2 c3. So, simplifying, square root of c1 r c3 by 2 plus square root of c1 r c3 by 2. This will be 2 times of square root of c1 c3 r. So, simplifying further, the cost equal to, optimum cost equal to square root of 2 c1 c3 r. So, this is the optimum cost. The three important equations that you have to remember. So, TO, we have to remember the TO. TO equation you have to remember. TO equal to 2 C3, square root of 2 C3 by C1 R. And QO you have to remember, R TO. And CO you have to remember, cost, optimum cost you have to remember, square root of 2 C1 C3 R. Now, we take up a numerical example. Example 1, a company purchases 10,000 items per year for the use of its production shop. The unit cost is rupees 10 per year and the holding cost is 0.8 per month. The cost of making purchase is rupees 200. Determine the following if no shortage is allowed. One is optimum order quantity. Two, optimal total yearly cost, number of orders per year, and time interval between the orders. So, we are given uniform demand rate, R equal to 10,000 per year. Holding cost, C1 equal to 0.8 per month. This is equal to 9.6 per year. Setup cost equal to 200. Unit cost equal to 10. So, we have to calculate optimal order quantity. So, optimal order quantity QO equal to square root of 2 C3 R by C1. So, it is equal to 2 into 200 into 10,000 divided by 9.6 equal to 645.5 equal to 646 items. And the total cost, optimal total yearly cost equal to cost of the item plus inventory cost. So, demand into unit rate, that is what the cost of the item, plus 2 square root of 2 C1 C3 R. So, 10,000 into 10 plus square root of 2 into 9.6 into 200 into 10,000. The cost is 10,000, 106,196.8 rupees, 106,196.6. Then time between the orders, TO equal to square root of 2 C3 by C1 R, which is 2 into 200 divided by 9.6 into 10,000 equal to 0.645 years, which is 0.774 months. And number of orders per year equal to N equal to 1 by TO, which is 1 by 0.0645 equal to 15.5 orders per year. So, these are all the answers to the problem. We take another example, example number 2. A factory uses annually 24,000 units of raw material, which costs rupees 1.25 per unit. Placing each order costs rupees 25 and the carrying cost is 6% per year of average inventory. Find the economic ordering quantity and the total inventory cost, including the cost of the material. So, you are given uniform demand rate of 24,000 per year. Setup cost is rupees 25. And unit cost is 1.25. Carrying cost is 6% per year. So 0.06 into 1.25 equal to 0.075 per year. Now the optimal order quantity or economic ordering quantity QO equal to square root of 2 C3 R by C1, which is square root of 2 into 25 into 24,000. divided by 0.075 equal to 4000 units. And the optimal total yearly cost, the cost of the item plus inventory cost. So, cost of the, this cost equal to demand into unit rate, that is the cost of the item plus inventory cost is square root of 2C1C3R. Substituting 24,000 into 1.25 plus square root of 2 into 0.075 into 25 into 24,000 equal to 30,300. So, rupees 30,300 is the optimal total yearly cost. We take another example. Example 3, find the optimum EOQ, economic ordering quantity for the following. Annual usage 1000 pieces, cost per piece rupees 250, ordering cost 6 per order, expediting cost rupees 4 per order, inventory holding cost 20% of the inventory, material handling cost rupees 1 per order. The solution to the problem, demand rate is 1000 pieces per year, cost of the pieces rupees 250. Holding cost is 20%, C1 equal to 20%, so 0.2 into 250 equal to 50 per piece per year. Ordering cost, so the setup cost equal to ordering cost plus expediting cost plus material handling cost. So, this is split at 6 plus 4 plus 1 equal to rupees 11. Now, we have to calculate only the economic ordering quantity. Economic ordering quantity QO equal to square root of 2C3R by C1, square root of 2 into 11 into 1000 divided by 50 equal to 21 pieces. So, 21 pieces is the economic ordering quantity in the model. So, we stop here. These are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You find the operation research book. You can use the book for your preparation. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel. Use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification or notes on the subject. So, we'll meet again another lecture on the inventory model. Until then, bye-bye.